In geomorphology, we study different processes at landforms. For example, fluvial, glacial, periglacial, aeolian, etc. Now let us study the semi-arid processes and landforms. As we know that in hot deserts, there is an arid region, and in arid region, wind blows that causes fluvial process. And just in the vicinity of arid, there is a semi-arid region. But in semi-arid region, it is not aeolian process that is so much active. Rather, it is fluvial process. The main process in semi-arid region is fluvial, because this area experiences some amount of rainfall. The annual rainfall amount is 40 to 80 centimeter, and that's why here fluvial process predominates. According to the UNEP, United Nations Environment Program report, about 40% of the land area is arid and semi-arid, arid and semi-arid collectively. So, if according to Thornthet, you want to keep the sequence of arid to humid in mind, this is arid region. Arid region means rain below 40 centimeter. But if rain is between 40 and 80 centimeter, it is semi-arid. And when rain exceeds that, that will become subhumid, then humid, then perhumid. Here, this semi-arid region. And as we have discussed that between semi-arid and arid, there is one belt of loess. Loess is a soil or alluvial or aeolian deposit by wind process, one layer, then fluvial process, next layer. Thus, in sequence, there is alternate deposition of sand and clay by fluvial process. This is the reason that loess region is very much fertile, because it is minerally rich as well as it is rich in humus brought by the fluvial process. So, loess is a very important deposition, fertile land found between arid and semi-arid. Now, let us concentrate ourselves to hear this semi-arid process and region. As we know that in semi-arid areas, if there is some low-lying area surrounded by a mountain hill or hillock from one side, from two sides, or from all the sides, that low-lying area is called balsam. And as rainfall occurs on this mountain, why rainfall will occur? If wind is coming from this side and this is lake, playa lake, having some water, where evaporation will take place, and that evaporated moisture will be carried by this wind, and as this wind will rise up the mountain, temperature will decrease, condensation will take place in a little amount, and rainfall will occur here. The rainwater will erode through different processes like solution, corrosion, and thus here of surface, here means on the upper segment of mountain, the surface will become smooth. This smooth surface caused by fluvial process is called pediment. Pediment is erosional surface by fluvial process. Then whatsoever material is being rolled down becomes of circular shape, and it takes the form of bajada. Bajada means large size of pebbles, cobbles, and these are deposited not on steeper slopes but at the foothill of mountain where slope becomes gentle, it is being deposited. So first topography or relief is pediment, second is bajada, and third is playa. As you know that this bouldered landscape cannot contain water. Water flowing from upper part of mountain will pass through the seepage between the boulders, and this water will accumulate in this low-lying area. This low-lying area is called balsam. It means balsam is depression or low-lying area, which is found in semi-arid regions, and it is surrounded by mountain from one side, two side, or all side. Balsam is a crossing in Allahabad, and it is located near two very prominent places of India. One is Bharadwaj Ashram and the other is Anand Bhavan. Tourists from India and abroad generally visit these two places, and they find balsam crossing having two higher land in the neighboring area. But balsam is actually in semi-arid region. We will discuss those. And small ephemeral rivers or temporary rivers flowing from these areas are called wadi. Wadi are found in Iran, Iraq, China, semi-arid region. And these wadis have here centripetal drainage pattern. It means balsam has centripetal drainage pattern. When water comes from here and is accumulated in low-lying area, this water is called playa. The term playa has originated from Mexico, Sonoran Desert in Southwest United States. Thus, today, playa has become a common term, and the character of playa is number one, centripetal drainage pattern found located in semi-arid areas. And as you know that this is semi-arid region. Semi-arid region is characterized with high evaporation, less rainfall, means evaporation exceeds rainfall. That's why due to high temperature and evaporation, the salt of subsurface structures is being brought on the surface through capillary action. As rain occurs, the surface salt is being carried down and deposited in this balsam area and in this playa waters. So, question may be, the water of playa will be salty or fresh? Answer is very much clear. It will be salty. As you know that this is semi-arid region, hence the water of playa will be evaporated during summer season. When water will get evaporated, its salt will be left, and salt will be deposited in the bottom of this playa lake, and this salt having some clay and silt will be here, and people take it away for their use. But animals also come here for grazing purpose, and if they have shortage of salt in their body, nature ask them to use this, and they chart it. Chart means it is Hindi word also. Because in Allahabad also, at balsam crossing, if you go, small children are seeing chart. They use chart. But chart has now become international word. One term is Nauk chart. Nauk chart is capital of Mauritania. Where is Mauritania? You can find in Atlas. Mauritania is a country in northwest Africa, and that is located in semi-arid region. That's why chart term has come from there. So you are now aware of this pediment, bajada, balsam, playa, chart, and now chart. Now let us understand some terms related with this. Pediment is erosional surface by fluvial process in semi-arid region. One term is pediment. Pediment means this plus this plus this. Means pediment includes pediment plus bajada plus playa. These three collectively are called pediment. Third term is piedmont. Piedmont means foothill of a mountain. Suppose this is a mountain, its foothill is this region. And this is a common word, not used only in semi-arid mountainous regions, rather everywhere. For example, Appalachian, Arauli, Himalayas, Caucasus, Rockies, all the mountains have piedmont. Piedmont means foothill region. Then there are some examples of playa. One question here is that whether this semi-arid region will be studied in fluvial process or in aeolian process. Actually, this answer should be given very wisely, because the book authors have put these semi-arid landform with aeolian process, but that is not correct. It is exactly fluvial process that works here. So this chapter, semi-arid, should be included in fluvial process. But in fluvial process, by geomorphological authors, it has not been put included. Why? Because in fluvial process, we study the process by water from the source of a river to the mouth, means delta of a river. While here, sources are here, the distance between source and mouth of this wadi is very short. So such landscapes as developed by rivers are not being developed here. That's why it is not included in fluvial process. But while answering UPSC, you will put it in fluvial process. Now, there are a number of examples of playa like Napta playa in Nubian desert and Wilcox, and a number of playa are there. But better to cram, it should be seen on the world map, because it also has a concept. Now let us study the examples and their location and importance of playa lakes in world. Here, this is map of world. But before looking at the map, let us have a general concept that here this is a wind process. This is aeolian process which develops erosional landforms here. This will be studied in detail. Depositional landform here. Thus, the aeolian process comes to an end at this line. Then starts semi-arid process, semi-arid landforms, in which, as we have discussed in the previous model, small streams which are temporary called wadi flow from here and deposit bajada and develop playa lakes here. So here playa is found, but in world, where playa found? Really, playa is a lake found in semi-arid region. Where semi-arid regions are found in world? These are found in proximity with arid regions. Where are arid regions or hot desert region? As you know that hot desert regions are located along the Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn, but to the west of the continent, like here Sodo Run Hot Desert, Sahara Desert, Arabian Desert, Desert Iran, here Thar Desert, West Australian Desert, Kalahari and Nubian Desert, and this Atacama Desert. It shows that all the arid landforms developed by Eurian process and semi-arid landforms developed by fluvial process will be found here, and the playa lakes having centripetal drainage pattern, saline water and salt pans will be found here. The best examples are race track playa near Death Valley in California. Next is Pilot Valley in Utah, state of United States, near Sonoran Desert. Next is Wilcox Playa, located in Arizona, United States, Sonoran Desert. Here, one is Nubian Desert in Egypt, located to the east of River Nile. Here is Napta Playa, which is of international importance. Aral Sea, located between Kazakhstan and Uzbekistan, is also an example of playa which has centripetal drainage pattern, because Sardaria and Amudaria rivers drain into it, and there is a series of salt bed and salty islands in this Aral Sea that is undergoing deposition at rapid rate. This is also a very good burning examples of playa, the existence of which is under risk. And here in Tehran, here in Iran, one playa is Petregan. Now let us reach India in Thar Desert to the northwest of Aravali, that is semi-arid region. There are several examples of playa lake. For example, Sambhar, Kuchman, Degna, Didwana. These salt lakes are playa lakes having centripetal drainage pattern. Thus, in North Hemisphere, playa lakes are located along a line nearly parallel to the Tropic of Cancer. In South Hemisphere, in West Australian Desert, there is a lake Disappointment, an example of playa. Likewise, here is a Lake Eyre, the lowest salty lake in Australia continent. Here in South Africa, there is one Lake Nagami, in which small streams, desert streams or wadis drain into forming centripetal drainage pattern. Nagami Lake is an example of playa. In the same way, Atacama Desert has also small playa lakes. So, after studying location of playa and the cause of their existence, now let us understand its importance. As we know that the playa water is salty and it is in semi-arid region. In summers, as the water evaporates, the salt gets exposed. People come and collect that salt. Thus, there is salt culture. For example, in India, you take Lake Sambhar, Kuchman, Degna, Didwana. Here, salt mining is practiced on large scale. So, there are two areas of salt involved. Number one, along the Tropic of Cancer and Capricorn. There too, two specific areas. One, along the coast, which are located near the desert. For example, coast of Gujarat, located near Thar Desert. Likewise, along the west coast of the country, located along Kaisar and Caprikar, along coastline, salt is found. Second source, second deposit of salt is Playa Lakes. So, those two salts are of different nature. Marine or coastal salt differs in character from the salt found in Playa, but both are of human use. So, after having a good knowledge, exact knowledge of geography, you can live in world, you can get service, do service, you can do business also, for example, of salt. If you have to purchase salt from Norway and Canada and sell in this region, you will suffer deficit. So, better to purchase salt from these two belts cheaper and sell them in middle and higher latitudes where there is no salt. Salt possibility is not there. It means our nature is benign enough to have bestowed us or the world people with salt. That's why the arid and semi-arid regions are also important for the survival of us in the world.